Hi, Murdoch here. We're going to look at a short chip shot, basic chipping action. Now, I believe all of you from watching maybe other YouTube videos or just your experience are probably going to understand how you stand to these. So I'm going to just brush over that because I want to talk more about the sort of mental approach you take to these. The process in which you take to commit to the shot, to get the strike and the timing. This happens first before you get the feel and the range. So let me explain this. I got 12, 14 feet of semi-rough fringe before I reached the green. I got a 58 degree. I've got sort of 12 feet of green and then the flag. So it's a kind of lofted shot. Maybe a 54 you can play it with. I got a 58, but you don't want anything straighter than that. We want to try and play it where there's a little bit of check, a committed strike, add a semi-rough grass, and then minimal run. So we're going to stand with a very narrow stance, and we want the weight to be leaning on our front foot. A good portion of it, I'm going to say about 80%. Down the handle, face will be slightly open, ball will be in the center. Hands will be slightly forward just from the way you're leaning on that left side and the ball in the middle with your hands low. Your hands will be promoted slightly ahead of the ball. The process, you want to feel like you're striking it briskly. I like striking a match analogy. Imagine your club head is the matchstick, the ground is the striking board. So I want you to do a few practice swings now, just thinking about that. We don't care where it goes. Our goal is strike with this striking match. So leaning on that left side, hands low, face slightly open. Imagine that you're striking this club head. Keep it moving. It's not a long swing. It's not a very wristy swing. Leaning forward, hands forward. It's a pulling through. Not so far back, not so far through, just giving yourself a brisk strike into the roots, not taking divots, but brushing the base of the grass here in a striking match. Think about that briskness you have, and you're going to strike that club head alight. Okay, now that's your goal, all right? That is now your goal. Don't care where it goes. I want you to strike the match. Strike the match. Two in a row, three in a row. You're cloning it. You'll feel the crispness in the strike. You'll start to see the ball reacting in a positive way, a little bit of spin. This is assuming you're not playing with a hard distance golf ball. A softish cover, Pro V1, Titleist, or similar will certainly get that reaction you're after with a good strike. Then you'll start to see a pattern. You'll start to see a pattern develop from just this consistency you've now developed. You'll start to see a range happen. I'm in the rough cut, which is about 4 inches, 5 inches long. When the grass is this long, you've got a harder job to keep the club moving. So what you need to do is just be a little bit more committed to this striking the match, okay? We've still got our weight favoring the left side. I'm on a slight upslope here. My face is open. Because I'm on an upslope, I'm going to get the height. I've just got to keep the club moving under the ball. So I'm going to feel like I'm playing that dragging through. My left wrist is firm. The club head is the match. I'm lighting it against the grass. I want three good practice swings, and then my third one being the best of the three, is my blueprint that I try and commit to best I can and not care about the outcome. So three practice swings. I've kind of got the shot in my mind, so I know how hard I want to hit it. Now I go with the third one in my mind. That's the goal, nothing else. And there we go. Hope you enjoyed this. Like and subscribe if you want more. And please feel free in the comments to suggest some other topics that you're having difficulty with. I'll be very happy to make a video. See you next time.